Hi, welcome to my first video blog comparing PHP framework. As a first video blog, I have probably selected a controversial topic because there are many people who love particular framework. They can't listen other framework is good, but that is just my way of selecting a right framework for my next project. A bit introduction about me. I am Kapil Sharma, working as a technical architect at Eastern Enterprise. I'm Zend certified PHP engineer as well as Zend certified Zend Framework 2 architect. I'm working in web application development since 12 plus years. My contact information, Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn are there. You can find all of my slides, including this one, although that's just a 14-15 page slide, on speakerdeck.com/Kapil Sharma. And phpreboot.com, that's a community website of PHP developers in Pune. You can find this and more videos on that. Before we go ahead, I want to be 100% clear, that is just my personal opinion, and this opinion served me very well till now. Yes, each and every framework is good if it is used in the right way and for the purpose it serves best. So it depends on what your requirement is. If there is a framework, then it must be good at something. Again, being as a technical architect, I have to select a right tool for next project, and that is just a part of my job. And whatever I am going to discuss in this section is how I select them. For my professional experience, I had professionally worked on commercial projects using CodeIgniter, Symfony, Zend Framework, and Laravel. Although I didn't work on commercial projects, but for some hobby projects or for learning purpose, I'd also worked on CakePHP, Lumen, Slim Framework, or Silex. So there is nothing best. So if you're looking this video, assuming you can find the best framework for you, no, you will not, because there's nothing best. If something is bad, it means others does not exist. And if exist, they will not survive. Obviously, if one thing is best, everyone will be using it, and others will not able to compete. So, as a whole story, nothing is best. If there are 100 frameworks, they must be good at something. So, who are the target audience? This session is for you. If you're a senior developer who need to decide a right framework for your next project, or maybe you are a junior developer looking for a first framework to learn. No, that might not be for that. But again, it is strictly not for those who knows what framework serves them best and working with it. If you are working with any framework and it is serving you best, then you probably don't need to change your framework. Just continue with that. And again, there might be few people who are in love with any particular framework that they cannot accept the fact that other frameworks can also do good. If you are such kind of person, then obviously you are not going to like my first video blog. So again, I'm saying again, this video is strictly about how I select frameworks for my next project. How do I? So I basically divide all the frameworks. Before that, being a technical architect, I am not even 100% sure to use PHP. If for any particular project, some other language, for example Node.js or Python or anything, if that language can serve well, I will not hesitate to use that language. And again, even in PHP world, there are frameworks as well as CMS. So for this video, I am assuming we have selected PHP as a programming language and ruled out CMS. So we are just comparing the frameworks. So for frameworks, I basically divide it into three parts: full-fledged frameworks, micro-frameworks, or mid-level frameworks. So what are full-fledged frameworks? We'll go into details, but I keep just two frameworks in that category, Symfony and Zend Framework. And as I already told, I'm ZF2 certified architect, so most of the time I should be recommending Zend Framework, but actually I do not. If I have to select a full-fledged framework for a project, Most of the time my preference goes with Symfony, even though I'm a ZF certified architect. I have my own reasons for that, but let's leave it for now. Among micro frameworks, there are four popular: Slim Framework, Zen Framework Expressive, Lumen by Laravel. ZF Expressive is by Zen, Lumen by Laravel, or Stylex by Symfony. In mid-level frameworks, there's obviously Laravel, Cake PHP, Y, and yeah, CodeIgniter. Well, CodeIgniter was the first framework I started working with in, I guess, 2009 or 2010. And I worked on commercial projects using CodeIgniter for next 3 to 4 years. So obviously I love CodeIgniter, but I really, really believe CodeIgniter is not good in today's world. I'll come to that. And again, if someone is thinking why only 10 frameworks, why not more? There are hundreds of frameworks in PHP. So yes, these are the 10 frameworks I just looked because they are very popular, they have a huge community, and they have active development. So when I was selecting a framework for my new project, I personally look at these 10, no other. Again, among them, CodeIgniter is out of questions. I already said why. So now let's go a little deeper into that. What is full-fledged frameworks? So as the name suggests, it has nearly everything. It has a huge library. Obviously, if you have to write your own business logic, it will not have your business logic. But other than your business logic, whatever you are going to need, they have everything. And the best part I love in full-fledged framework is there are multiple ways of doing one thing. So it basically do not force their style on you. It let you do your code in your style. And that is the best part I like in full-fledged frameworks like Symfony and Zen framework. Yes, there are some disadvantages as well. If you have a huge library, obviously there is going to be a steep learning curve and comparatively slower. That could be controversial. You can apply caching, you can apply opcode caching and many things to make your application perform well. But that is out of question. I'm just speaking about the bare minimal Hello World app. For that, it is obviously slower than other frameworks. But again, it is good for used products or enterprise application. Now, there's a confusion what I mean exactly by enterprise application. So my definition of enterprise application, a project that has to be worked by multiple developers continuously or at least for a very, very long time. By very long time, I say 4 to 5 years. So if you have a project in mind where you have to work for 4 to 5 years continuously with multiple developers, then definitely go for full-fledged framework. It will need some time to learn, but it will pay really well. Then coming to micro frameworks, they have very tiny footprint. That's both advantage as well as disadvantage. If it is a very small library, very small things, obviously it is easier to learn. Performance-wise, it will be faster, but it is also a disadvantage. They have very minimal things. That means developers have to spend more time developing. But again, they are very good for small applications. Now, what is the definition of a small application? It could be a simple static website with just one or two dynamic pages like contact us page and maybe some sending few mails. But again, a page with hundreds of dynamic web page, for me, that is also a small web application. So don't gauge by my wordings, a small web application. I guess most of the project that we do are small web applications. Then they are very good for mobile backends. All mobile applications, not all, but most of the mobile applications need some support from the backend server. And at that time, micro frameworks are very good. Then mid-level frameworks, they fall somewhere in between. I will never use a mid-level framework for an enterprise application, but it could be used. Don't get confused by my words. We can make enterprise application with mid-level frameworks. Only thing is that they somehow force you to do things in a particular way. And if you have a huge application, huge enterprise application, you want more freedom. Maybe more work, but more freedom. So they are actually safe bet. Safe bet for if you want to make enterprise application or you want to make a small application and you can learn only one framework, then I would say go for mid-level framework. They'll work for a small app as well as enterprise application. But again, there's disadvantage. I would say it's a Swiss Army knife, fit for all. And whenever there is a thing called fit for all, they have their own disadvantage. So what exactly you need? So now we know what are different kind of frameworks. So we obviously don't need a silver bullet. Those who are not aware, silver bullet, we can say it's a special solution that fits in each and every condition. But in the real world, there is no silver bullet. So how do we decide? We have a specific requirement. Again, you might have your specific limitations. Maybe you have very tight budget, maybe you have like limited time period, maybe you have a very small team, not very experienced. So you might have your own limitations, and again, each and every project has a specific requirement. So if there is a specific thing, you need a specific solution, not generic. So no framework will fit in each and every condition. So what to consider? I would say there are a few points which I generally consider. What you're making, most of the time, I guess it's a you're a professional, so you're making a good professional application. But yes, it could be academic or it could be a hobby project. Maybe you're making academic project. So in that case, I would say just learn as much as you can. And that is true even for hobby projects. You are in the learning phase. So learn as much as you can. Do not limit yourself to a single framework. Learn as many frameworks as you can. But if you are a professional, then it depends on what are your requirements. But again, if you are a professional, then you have some professional duty towards your client. So project requirement, what is your project size? Maybe it could be a 100-hour project or even less. Or it could be say continuous project to be executed for several years. Then functional requirements, it could have a straightforward requirement. You need to make some simple web pages, or you have very, very complex business logic. So it depends on functional requirement, and also budget is also important. By budget, it is directly proportional to time. If you have tight budget, you will get less time. And again, quality requirements. Now, that is a thing that most of the developers neglect, and I really hate that. If you are a professional and your client is non-technical, it doesn't mean give them anything. Yes, functional requirement is important, but future extendability, following coding best practices, even if your client cannot give those things, being a professional, it is your responsibility to give a proper quality product. And again, I would recommend invest some time for that. Again, then current knowledge is important. What is your team size? You may be an individual freelancer, or you could have a small team, or you can have a very large team. If especially in case you have a good team, then not only your knowledge but the team knowledge. Say you know one framework, say for example Symfony, and none of your team members know Symfony. So learning Symfony will be more costly, but all of your team knows say for example Zend framework and you don't know, So only you have to learn one framework. So current knowledge is important. We have to invest minimal time for learning. And I would say learning time should be the personal time. So team size is also for that. Now what? Conclusion. It's your project. You decide it yourself. I have given you some points. You will never allow anyone. No one can tell you what is your favorite color. Would you ask someone what is my favorite color? Or would you ask someone what should I have in dinner today? It's your choice. Understand your requirements. All these are the parameters you should consider. Understand your requirements, and based on your requirements, first you can categorize. You need a full-fledged framework, or you need a micro framework, or fit all mid-level framework. Once you decide, then you can probably go with that frameworks, learn a bit more about them, and then decide which is best fit for you. But still, if you are still confused and still want someone to decide what is your favorite color, what is your, the menu of your dinner tonight, well, I will do it. But again, that is not a good question, because most of the time, then I will give you my preference, not your preference. But still, if you are undecided, because I see a lot of such questions on internet, mainly by the junior developers, or maybe, oh, what should be the first framework I learn. So if you still want me to suggest one framework, then I have some assumptions about you. And if any of these assumptions is correct, then only go with my advice. You have a small team or a freelancer. Obviously, why it is important. And again, if you are looking up someone else to tell you which framework you should use, that means you don't know any framework right now. That is my assumption. If you know any framework, I would say just stick with that, at least for the product projects. And that team also have experience of less than 3 years, because if you have experience of, if you have 5 developers all having experience of 3+ years, then I'm sure at least one of you know should know at least one framework. So that is my assumption. Again, my another assumption, you are a service-based company, which are getting low budget projects. Don't get me wrong, don't get offended, just my assumption, it could be wrong. And again, you could be making a new product, you're non-technical, but you don't want to hire some technical person until you have minimal viable product. So if these are the conditions, I would say go for safe bet or mid-level framework. And what in mid-level framework? Again, this is my preference. I suggest don't go with my preference. Decide what your preference is. But if you still want me to suggest, from my personal experience, I would suggest Laravel. Why? There are a few more. There's YI, there's CakePHP. Just because of community size, most of the community is going with Laravel. Again, it should not be like everyone is going in one direction, then I should also go in that direction. No, it is not. The only reason that you will get maximum help for that. And if you are learning a framework and there is no senior person to guide you, then this community is going to be very crucial. That is my only reason to suggest Laravel. It's not just because I work it. And again, if you go with my choice of Laravel, then there are few suggestions. I would say you will need at least 5 days to learn, but again, 5 days is the minimum amount you should invest. So I would say day one, maybe you can go for Laracast trainings. They have very good trainings. If you want to see the, there's a website, laracast.com, and it provides free trainings, not only in Laravel, but in many. So if you go to the site, you can go and browse now. And after that, skills you can shortlist by Laravel. And as of now, it is the Laravel 5.4 from scratch. but it is just because Laravel 5.4 is the latest version at the time of this recording. If you go with that, it's a free tutorials, and they are very, very good tutorial. It is just 32 lessons, but if you go a 6 minute, 4 minute, 4 minute, the biggest I guess is a 20 minutes. So ideally speaking, you can complete all of them in one day. On day two, I would suggest read the Laravel docs. So if you Google Laravel docs, got a first link that is the documentation of Laravel, and it is very good. It will need some time, but I would say on day two, read it as a novel. At least read starting to end as a novel. If you get it, or even if you don't get it, just read it. That's what I basically suggest to all the newcomers in my company. Day one, go with Laraka Studios. Day two, read all the documents as a novel. Why it is important? Because when you stuck on a particular topic in your project, you will at least know where to look for the help, and that is most crucial. Then next 3 days, maybe you make a small project, and that's all. That will be enough for your Laravel training. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me under the comments below or on Twitter. I have already shared my Twitter detail. And if you want to add or subtract something in this video, please feel free to add the comments. Thank you.